Big announcement in the world of boxing. John Molina Jr. is going to step into the ring March 7th to face Adrien, the problem, Broner. John, first of all, you had a chance to meet Broner this week.
Yeah.
Any exchange of words?
Just, you know, we both told each other to be ready for a war. That's all.
Very professional.
Very professional. Kept it 100% professional. I told him I'll be ready. He said he's going to be ready. So it's going to be a fireworks come March 7th.
You're very talented. He's very talented. He's a three-time world champion. It wasn't long ago people said he's the next Mayweather. He's the next biggest thing in boxing. A huge fight for you.
Very big fight. Now it's my job to disrupt that. And that's what we plan on doing. Adrien Broner is his accolades speak for itself. He's done wonders in the sport already. A very young champion, three different weight divisions. You can't talk about that in a bad way. That's a good thing. So we definitely know what we're in for, and we're preparing ourselves extremely well for this fight.
What does John Molina need to do to win this fight?
Knockout. You don't play chess with Bobby Fischer. The guy is
Bobby Fischer is a very good chess player.
Exactly. So I wouldn't play chess with him. I'm gonna go out and make it a brutal fight. That's my game plan.
What do you tell Adrien Broner if he's watching?
I'll see you March 7th. Like I always say, we'll see you March 7th. We'll be ready, and I'm sure he's gonna be ready. It's gonna be a good night of boxing.
What do you like about his boxing?
I think his showmanship is what sells him more than anything.
He's great at what he does.
He's good at what he does. I wouldn't say he's great, but he's good at what he does, and it's gonna make an intriguing fight because you have two different polar opposite styles going in that night, March 7th. So I think NBC, a great platform, 130 million homes it'll be in. It's gonna be a great night of boxing for boxing.
You flew to New York for the press conference. Then you had 2 days of photo shoots in LA. How did it go?
It was good. I mean, at this level, you gotta delegate some time for promotion, and we prepared ourselves to do so. And like I said, it was fun. It was a unique experience. And now all the fun stuff's behind us. Now it's time to go to war.
John, did you face off with him?
We did one time in NBC. Again, like I said, to my surprise, he was very, very, very professional.
He's a very nice person.
Nice guy, very professional. But again, when we get in that ring, all that goes out the window. It's business.
This is the biggest fight of your career to date.
Yeah.
Matisse was fighted a year. You're starting a brand new year. What have you heard from the fan base since they announced the fight?
The fans are behind me, and I appreciate that because they know I bring it in the ring every time I fight. And that's what I'm going to do. I'm the hardcore fans that really support me, that are really behind me, that know I'm just a workhorse and someone that grinds to get to where I'm at. Like I said, I took the scenic route. I wasn't supposed to be here, but I'm here now, and I'm going to prove my point March 7th.
Another fight on your card is Guerrero against Thurman. Fireworks.
A 50-50 fight, in my opinion. Both very talented fighters. Guerrero is never in a bad fight. Thurman is always in an interesting fight. And I think stylistically, it's going to make a war. So I think March 7th is going to be a great, great card for boxing. And I think Al Haymon outdid himself on this one, putting all this on Channel 4, NBC, and 130 million homes across the world, not nationwide, worldwide. So it's going to be a beautiful thing for boxing.
John Molina is known for his power. What will fans see that they don't know you for? Do you think you're going to show them something new, different, or?
That's to be announced. March 7th, you know, we got to hold something back. So March 7th, you guys tune in, have a barbecue, sit down, relax, sit around the TV. If you can't make it out to the MGM Grand March 7th, it's going to be a great night of boxing. And like I said, it's going to be a war.
Reporting.
Last thing, have you ever fought anyone similar to Broner or his style in your career?
I mean, every man is different. I can say yes, I can say no. I mean, our job is to get the best guy to emulate Adrien Broner, which you're going to have a handful of guys because he's so diverse in the ring. So, again, I fought everyone but Adrien Broner. So, March 7th, I'm going to fight Adrien Broner. I'll tell you firsthand exactly what it's all about.
I talked to the big man who just became a WBC heavyweight champion, Deontay Wilder. He said good things about you. Everybody in Vegas had good things to say about you.
That's a good, like I said, I think the fans can appreciate what I do, what I bring to the table, how hard I work. You know, and we're very excited about this fight. You know, this is a golden opportunity, and we're not going to let it slip through our fingers.
Message to your fans?
Thank you so much for the support. Thank you to everyone who knows who I am, even the guys that don't talk so good about me. Thank you. Thank you guys for paying attention.
You got haters?
Everyone has haters. Floyd Mayweather has haters, and he's the best in the world. So, you know, that's just part of the game. You just get, when you're in the public eye, you got to learn to deal with it, take it with a grain of salt. But everyone that supports me, thank you guys very much. I'm going to do everything I can to put on a great show. And it's going to be a fight of the year, I can guarantee that.
There you have it. John Molina Jr. against Adrien Broner. March 7th, it will be an amazing fight. Stay tuned for EsNews.com and Ballistic Back Reporting. You know what's funny, John? I don't have haters.
Yeah. Everyone has haters. You know, Rob Schneider told me best. He said, you don't pay attention to that. You just go out and do your job. You know, these guys are, you know, everyone has opinions. And they're entitled to them. So we're not worried about that from that perspective. We're just out there to do our job and be the best John Molina Jr. I hate talking to myself in third person, but being the best John Molina Jr. we can be.
How did you like the whole NBC experience?
It was amazing.
A class,
110%, rolled out the red carpet. My manager, Al Heyman, did it right. And it's going to set the bar. It's going to set the standard for boxing.
Wilder against Tyson Fury. I said 30 seconds, Wilder knocks him out.
Hey, you know, Wilder answered a lot of questions that night. You know, a lot of people questioned his chin, which you can't compare an amateur fight to a professional fight. You can't do that, otherwise you'd be sadly mistaken. He proved he can go past four rounds, and Severn's a real opponent. He's a real devastating puncher.
Great fighter.
A great heavyweight, and I don't think it's the end of the road for Severn. I think he'll be back. So it was a good night. It was the most entertaining heavyweight fight that we've seen in a long time, so I'm excited to see what's next for both of them.
Manny Pacquiao Mayweather.
If it does happen,
I talked to Manny this morning. He told me I signed my contract.
If it does happen, it'll be great for boxing. If it doesn't happen, well, whoever they get in the ring with next, hopefully it'll be good for boxing.
All right, there you have John Molina Jr. You can follow him on Instagram and on Twitter.
At John Molina Jr. 135.
Even though
we're at 140.
He's not changing his name.
I'm not going to change it.
FaceTheReport.com. Malik Segback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, at Segback. Now you're going to see how he gets his six-pack. Go to the body, man. Go to the body.